Yamaha. The name alone evokes images of roaring engines and screaming fans. Since the dawn of MotoGP, Yamaha has been a force to be reckoned with. For decades, they've been at the forefront, pushing the boundaries of motorcycle racing. Their bikes are known for their speed, agility, and cutting-edge technology. They have a long history of victories and championships. Yamaha's trophy cabinet is packed with legendary names, riders like Wayne Rainey, Eddie Lawson, and Kenny Roberts. These legends cemented Yamaha's place in the Hall of Fame. Then came Valentino Rossi, the modern-day icon. He brought Yamaha a new level of dominance in the 2000s. From 2004 to 2009, Yamaha was unstoppable. Rossi, on his Yamaha M1, was unbeatable. He racked up 4 world championships during this period. The M1, with its inline-four engine, was a masterpiece of engineering. It was the envy of the paddock. Yamaha was at the top of the world. They had the fastest bikes, the best riders, and a winning formula. But as the saying goes, what goes up must come down. After years of dominating MotoGP, Yamaha hit a rough patch. The competition caught up. They started to struggle to keep pace. The once dominant M1 began to show its age. Yamaha seemed to rest on their laurels. They didn't innovate at the same rate as their rivals. Other manufacturers like Honda and Ducati were pushing harder. They were developing new technologies and taking risks. Yamaha, on the other hand, became complacent. They stuck with what they knew, and it cost them. The results spoke for themselves. Yamaha started to slip down the standings. Wins became scarce. Their riders, once the envy of the grid, were visibly frustrated. The once mighty Yamaha was losing its edge. By 2023, Yamaha knew they had to make a change. The once dominant force in MotoGP was in danger of becoming an also-ran. They needed to take a long, hard look in the mirror. They needed to find their way back to the top. In late 2023, Yamaha initiated a comprehensive review. They analyzed every aspect of their operation. They talked to their engineers, their mechanics, and most importantly, their riders. Yamaha realized they had become too set in their ways. They hadn't been listening to their riders, the ones who knew the bikes best. This introspection was a turning point. Yamaha acknowledged their mistakes. They knew they needed to be bold. They needed to innovate. They needed to listen. This led them to a radical decision. It was time to ditch the inline-four engine that had been their trademark for so long. It was time for something new. It was time for the V4. Section 4, the V4 engine, a new era of Yamaha dominance. The announcement came at the 2024 Tokyo Auto Salon. Yamaha's technical director, Max Bartolini, took the stage. He had a twinkle in his eye and a confident smirk. He announced that Yamaha would be switching to a V4 engine for the 2025 season. The crowd gasped. The paddock went into overdrive. The V4 engine was a bold statement. It was a sign that Yamaha was serious about regaining its crown. V4 engines, popular in American motorcycles like Harley-Davidson's, were known for their raw power and torque. Could Yamaha harness this power and translate it to MotoGP success? The buzz around the new engine was palpable. Testing began immediately. The initial reports were positive. The riders were impressed with the power delivery and handling. It seemed like Yamaha had a winner on their hands. Section 5, the road ahead. A future filled with promise. As we stand on the cusp of the 2025 MotoGP season, excitement is building. Yamaha, with its revolutionary V4 engine, is poised for a resurgence. The team is energized, the riders are confident, the fans are eager to see the new bike in action. The V4 engine is a game changer. It has the potential to propel Yamaha back to the top of the podium. But MotoGP is a fiercely competitive arena. Only time will tell if the new engine will bring Yamaha the success they crave. Will Yamaha return to its glory days? Will they dominate the field like they did with Rossi at the helm? Only time will tell. But one thing is for sure, Yamaha is back and they are here to stay. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Do you think the V4 will bring Yamaha back to the top?